see, this is the output from the casting machine, and this is a one push button where the meshing has been created and all the stitching and the insertion has been taken care by the tool automatically. So the next one where the problematic area is going to come is, how do we do the mesh modification very quickly? That is, if at all we need to do any kind of a stitching or feature insertion manually, that is possible, and that I'm going to take care in the second part of the demonstration. And as you can see, this is the output, and all the features that are there in the CAD has been captured in the mesh also. So this is an option which the user preferably uses, and if that is not so, the user can just ignore this option as well. And the third one is, as you can see, almost all the ribs are being inserted, and in very few cases like this, after inserting there could be some dents in the model. And how are we trying to address this problem? So in all the planar regions, meshworks typically make sure that 100% it is on the plane, but all for the curved regions, we do have an automatic method. But even after this automatic method, if we are not able to correct it, user has an option to move all these nodes to the mid location. So I'm just going to select the assembly. By assembly, I mean a source and a target pair of surfaces and the elements, and say move. So all the nodes have been moved to the central location. I'm just going to do change in color. Yeah, and that's it. And similarly, before going on to the next step of the thickness assignment, the most tools that we'll be using is the remeshing tools and the tria movement. So if at all, if we have a bunch of trias that is there in a particular location, so we can use the move trias function. All the user needs to do is select the trias and then move it to a location. So if there is a constraint that on all the perimeters of the surfaces, there should not be any kind of trias, so user can quickly do all the modifications using this function. And similarly, if the user wants to remove the trias, or so in this case, it is a nose opposite tria, and if you want to remove the trias, we can just select this element and it finds the opposite trias, and we can just collapse them in one shot. So all the mesh editing functions, such as moving the elements to the plane and then doing all the necessary flow correction, remeshing options, are already there in Meshworks. And let me take you to this particular example where the mesh flow is not that much good. So I want to have a kind of a mesh flow like a pattern, so that during my thickness assignment, I would kind of get a layered thickness assignment. So for that, I can quickly go into the remeshing panel. So even though the elements, there is no CAD associated to this elements, we can do all the operations that the regular mesher can do with the surface. Meaning, I can just select these elements and then discretize these elements so that I can get a good mesh flow and say execute. And as you can see, the mesh flow has been aligned in a proper direction. So similarly, I can choose the other areas as well. So typically, I'm just trying to discretize these elements and getting a good flow so that it is going to be useful during my thickness assignment stage.